Bryan Suits is a rarity in radio, a host who served in the War on Terror and other deployments. While some choke up over their love of America, Bryan has put skin in the game. He fought in Desert Shield, Desert Storm, helping to liberate Kuwait. He fought in Bosnia, and he fought in the current Iraq war. After 14 months in Iraq, he came home with 3 wounds and a bronze star. He has been in radio for a while, in between fighting on America's behalf, and he now hosts the morning show on 570 KVI, as well as the military-oriented show called The Dark Secret Place on KFI Sundays. Please give this veteran of the United States of America a worthy applause.
Good evening, citizens. Have y'all read the 10th Amendment? Who here, I was asked by a member of the media, does anyone here actually think we can have a world in America with zero taxes?
No.
Is it the taxing or the spending?
Spending!
Wait, let me get this straight. Is it the taxing or the spending?
No.
Okay, because I come from the future. I just spent 2.5 years in California. I'm in a time machine. I just got back from California after 2.5 years in California. I've seen your future. You know what's happening to Greece and Europe? California. The dream is over. We're on that path, but we're not there yet. Largest income tax. Largest sales tax. Full-time legislature. They're broke. They're $550 billion broke. The majority, this happened this week, the majority of unionized employees in America work for government. So government is now run by the union. Who wants to move there? For the first time since the gold rush, since 1849, California is hemorrhaging people. California was a dream, wasn't it? We all wanted to live in California because who wouldn't want to live in California? It was a Ponzi scheme and it's collapsed because the music is over, the last person has moved out. They're hemorrhaging people and they're about to lose a congressperson. That's the roadmap. Are we on that roadmap or off that roadmap? Well, I think we're on that roadmap because I heard people talking about an income tax in Olympia. As long as we watch that, as long as we keep our legislature part-time, I don't mind them debating. And I also understand that when I call 911, I need a fire truck to show up. I want the cops to be paid, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But there's a limit, and it's in the 10th Amendment. You can't compel me to buy a product. If this year you force me to buy health insurance, what's to stop you next year from wearing a bike helmet? I never threw a lawn dart at anybody, but I can't buy them anymore. And I used to love lawn darts, by the way. And at the end of the day, and it is the spending, stupid, I'm glad we're all on the same page about that. But, oh, I'm sorry. I just moved back from California. Did y'all hear that part? Okay, I'll move back up here. I apologize. I just get the sense that I'm not being led and I'm not being governed, I'm being ruled. I'll grant this to the people who rested up all day because they don't work. Is this what it felt like for you when Bush was president? I don't know. But my problem is that I have the feeling that money is being demonized. It's what I hear all the time. Is what I hear is that when you're running for president in 2008, Wall Street is the enemy. Wall Street is the devil. Last week, Wall Street is evidence that there's a recovery. Well, we're still at 20% unemployment. Money is not the root of all evil. And run for your life from the person that demonizes money. Money is a method of exchange. I'm paraphrasing Ayn Rand. I highly recommend you all read Atlas Shrugged, but if you don't have a month and a half, run for your life from the person that demonizes money. Run for your life from that person. If what it boils down to, basically, and this is the highest tribute for America from a Russian emigre, Ayn Rand. This is why I love America, and this is what I would like to hear a president say, by the way. One of the really unique things about America is that we invented the phrase to make money. This is the first country that ever said to make money. And something clicked in me when this president was running for president and he told a guy, a plumber, that he wanted to spread the wealth around as if it's one thing, like it's one jar of peanut butter. You can print more money. And then that's our other problem, is that we can do math. We balance our checkbooks, and we know that we're being run by people that don't have that basic ability. And so basically, I just don't want money demonized. Money's not the problem. Business isn't the problem. The capitalists, the industrialists, and Amber Gunn, by the way, again, a shout out to the capitalists. If you own a small business, if you work for a living, that's what guarantees our freedom. That's really what this country is all about, is your individual chance to get better. I'm not keeping anybody poor. I'm not keeping, my steel-toed boot isn't on anyone's neck.
No.
But I do want the man to get his off mine, maybe someday. I just want everyone to have the same opportunities, and we do. I didn't make anybody poor. I'm trying to make me rich, and that doesn't make me a bad guy. And so at the end of the day, it boils down to, you can either have money as a method of exchange, or as Ayn Rand said, you can have guns and whips and chains. There's one or the other. Make your choice, because the time is coming fast. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Bryan. I really appreciate everything that you do now and everything that you did in the past when you were fighting for our country. And now I just want to take a minute to honor some people who make it possible for us to even be here today and do things like this, and that allows the differing dissenting opinions to be on the same street as each other, which is really an amazing thing when you look at most other countries that you can't do this in most other countries. I mean, there's a lot of countries that don't have as much freedom as we do, and that's something to honor. I want to honor the people that make this possible. And those people are the soldiers. I want to. But before I get your applause, I'd like to honor all of the past soldiers, so all the veterans here, current military members, people overseas, and especially those that have sacrificed something, the families and the soldiers that have paid the ultimate price with their lives. And I would also like to honor the Seattle police officers from last year. You know, I can't imagine what it would be like to wake up every day and not know what your day is gonna hold as far as coming home at night. It's an amazing thing that we have courageous people that volunteer to do this with their lives. And there were too many tragedies last year, and we've already lost two police officers this year. So I'm gonna read their names. And the reason I'm gonna read their names is because a memorial service I was at last year, someone was making some comments, and they said, always say the person's name. Say the person's name who has passed away, because then we never forget them. Don't be afraid to say their names. So I'm gonna read them off. One by one, the nine police officers that we've lost from last year to this year, and then we're gonna honor them. Stephanie and Rainey are gonna come back up and do a song for us. So this is just a thank you to all of the police officers and the members of the military that make it possible for us to be safe. Deputy Sheriff Stephen Michael Gallagher Jr., Officer Timothy Q. Brenton, Officer Tina G. Griswold, Officer Ronald Wilbur Owens II, Sergeant Mark Joseph Renninger, Officer Gregory James Richards, Deputy Sheriff Walter Kent Mundell Jr., Deputy Sheriff John Bernard, and Officer Bryan Walsh. And last year was also a pretty tragic year for Fort Lewis in Iraq and Afghanistan. So as we are here today, and we are protesting, and we are fighting for freedom, let's remember to honor all those that do it every single day.